Mom.
Okay, so today we're going to draw the American avocet. They're large, striking shorebirds, which mean they live by the water. They have long, bluish legs and a long, thin, upturned bill. They live in wetland habitats such as salt ponds, pothole lakes, and the mudflats of inland lakes. They feed by wading in open, shallow water using their highly sensitive bill either to catch prey they see first or to probe into the water to snatch prey that their bill touches. So they eat insects, shrimp, worms, small fish, and the seeds of water plants. They breed in the western United States, in Canada, and along the coasts of parts of California and Texas. This is their sound, and some pictures of them and their habitat. So when I look at birds, I'm always amazed at the fact that everywhere we go, we'll find them. Different kinds, and they're all around us. It really reminds me of God's presence. He's everywhere at all times. Jeremiah 23:23-24 says, "I am the God who is everywhere and not in one place only. No one can hide where I cannot see them. Do you not know that I am everywhere in heaven and on earth?" God is always here, near, to help us and to be there for us if we only draw near to him. When you're outside today, you should look for the birds and see how they're everywhere and always near, and be reminded that the Lord's presence is even nearer. So, let's get started.
What colors are we going to need? What color are we going to need?
We can't hear Baron talking.
Oh, okay, hold on. Can you talk more?
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. So we're going to need a yellowish brown, like this. And we're also going to need a dark brown, like that. And let's see, a black.
Already on.
And a green, a darkish green. And then a white. And then last of all, a blue, a light blue.
Okay, so let's get started.
We're going to draw first. We're going to start with his neck. So we're just going to do a little turn. It goes up like this. And then another curve that goes over the head. So this is going to be the head. And then we're going to curve this out a little bit like this, where the beak's going to be. Then we're going to come down here and do the other curve of the neck. And then we're going to do the bill that comes out. So this one's going to come in. It's going to come way out like this and then curve up. It looks kind of like a spoon.
We're having some technical difficulties.
I'll do that. So now we're going to bring the top part of the bill.
to make a point when we come to this part. Can you hear me okay? Thumbs up? Okay. So now to connect the beat, the top to the bottom, we're just going to do a wavy line that's kind of messy, that just goes up and then back down. And then we're going to make that same pattern underneath. Okay.
So now we're going to do that on the side of the beat. We're going to come right in the middle, all the way down.
And then to the tip. Then we're going to do a little oval to the nostril. And then a little circle to the side. Like that. We're going to go up like this. Like that.
Okay. Here we're going to do a little zigzag line that kind of turns like that. The neck. It's going to come.
It's going to start here, and it's going to come down in into the water. And this one is going to be out
and then up like this,
like he's taking a step.
So
with this one, we're just going to do a line out. And then this root is going to be the same level as this. It's going to come down and up. To be where we stopped with the line. It's going to be a little more this way.
That's the foot that's taking a step.
Pop at the end. But it's going to be a bump in. Find the leg.
Do the bump and then go down.
We're going to stop. Okay. Like this. And it looks a little funny right now, but it won't
in a minute. Because he's going to be in the water.
Okay.
Now, we're going to start up here with his feather design on his back. So, we're going to start here. Right here. Press it out. It kind of follows
that line in mid
here. It's going to come way out here like this. And then stop.
Curved up. Stop right there. Like that.
But it's a little bit smaller. In there. That. With the actual drawing. So we're just going to do up and down and then connect the bottom. Growing out of the water. And you can see that it's here. It's going to look
similar to this, how the reeds and the lake come out of the water. Okay,
so now we're going to color it. We're going to come in here with our yellowish brown, and we're going to do little ring, lightly shade, little ring shape that kind of follow the pattern of the net. I'm going to go back with our dark brown and do some in the middle. And do that same pattern. And also some underneath. Those are just going to fade out. And we're also going to follow that exact pattern
around the eye.
So try to follow the same pattern so it looks like it curved, the feathers are curved around the net, which they are. Line and the curved lines around the zigzaggy lines around the head, and then back with our dark brown and go over what we did with that. Then we're going to fade out back here. It fades from dark, and then it just goes out into nothing.
Cool.
We're done with the actual color. So now we're going to get our black, and we're going to do the shape. Our white and do a little bit of highlight right here. Now I'm going to use a brush tip pen. So you can also use a colored pencil if you like, and it's black.
This looks better than this.
I'm going to go back over with my dark brown and do more of those little curved lines and define it white just to get the not so messy. Bottom half of the beak. I'm going to go up and just do a little, just slightly shaped kind of top part. And then cover. So, Lizeth, if you're using a marker, and then go back over with your white and hold on a second. So you can go back over with your white. So I'm going to start with just a light blue, or light blue, and lightly shade the leg. After you shade lightly with blue, we're going to go back with a light gray. And
wait, what do we put over the blue?
Gray.
Okay.